the chemical kinetics for the second order reaction, we derive the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving single reactant and the second order reaction involving the two reactants. The second order reaction involving two reactants, it has two subcases. We derive the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactants for the two different cases. The subcase first, the second order reaction involving two reactants with equal initial concentration. For this condition, we derive the integrated rate equation and we also derive the integrated rate equation for the second order reaction involving two reactants with unequal initial concentration. The second order reaction involving single reactant, consider the second order reaction involving single reactant. The second order reaction involving single reactant. In this case, the integrated rate equation is K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T X upon A minus X. The second order reaction involving single reactant, the integrated rate equation is K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T X upon A minus X. This is the case first. For the case second, the second order reaction involving two reactants. The second order reaction involving two reactants. In this case, we consider this general reaction A plus B. It gives the product. For second order reaction involving two reactants, it has two subcases. Consider the subcase first. With equal initial concentration, the concentration of reactant A and B are equal. In this case, the integrated rate equation is similar to the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving single reactant. K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T X upon A minus X. The second order reaction involving single reactant and second order reaction involving two reactants with equal initial concentration have the integrated rate equation K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T X upon A minus X. Then consider this subcase second. The subcase second with unequal initial concentration. The reactant A and B have unequal initial concentration. In this case, the integrated rate equation is K2 is equal to 2.303 A minus B into T log B into A minus X upon A into B minus X. This is the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactants with unequal initial concentration. The second order reaction involving single reactant and second order reaction involving two reactants with equal initial concentration have the integrated rate equation. In both these cases are same. K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T X upon A minus X. Then we derive the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving single reactant and second order reaction involving two reactants for these two different surfaces with equal initial concentration and with unequal initial concentration. In today's lecture, we discuss the characteristic for the second order reaction. Then what are the characteristic for the second order reaction? Then consider the first characteristic for the second order reaction, the nature of graph or the graphical representation. The nature of graph or the graphical representation. In order to determine the graphical representation or nature of graph or second order reaction, then what is the integrated rate equation for second order reaction? The integrated rate equation or the rate constant equation for second order reaction. Second order reaction involving single reactant, the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving single reactant and two reactants with equal initial concentration is the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving single reactant and second order reaction with two reactants having equal initial concentration is K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T x upon A minus x. The K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T x upon A minus x. Then we can rearrange this equation. We rearrange this equation. X upon A minus x is equal to A. X upon A minus x is equal to K2 into A into K2 into T. This is the equation number 1. We can rearrange the integrated rate equation for the second order reaction involving single reactor and two reactants with equal initial concentration. Second order reaction involving single reactor and second order reaction involving two reactants with equal initial concentration have same integrated rate equation. K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T x upon A minus x. We can rearrange this equation in this form. X upon A minus x is equal to A into K2 T. This equation is a similar to the straight line equation y is equal to mx. This is the straight line which is passing through the origin. This equation are similar to the straight line equation. The straight line equation which is passing through the origin. The straight line which is passing through the origin by general equation y is equal to mx. Then this equation, the second order reaction equation, we can rearrange in this form, and this equation also similar to the equation y is equal to mx. Then we plotting the graph, m is a slope, we plot y against the x, we can obtain this straight line and this straight line passing through origin which having a slope m. This equation is a similar to straight line equation when we plot the graph x upon a minus x against this t, we can also obtain this straight line and this straight line also passing through the origin. We plot the graph x upon a minus x against the t. We obtain this straight line and the straight line has slope. The slope of this straight line is equal to a k2. By knowing the slope, we can determine the rate constant. K2 is equal to slope upon initial concentration. How to determine the graphical representation or nature of graph for second order reaction? We take the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving single reactant and two reactants with equal initial concentration. This is the integrated rate equation. K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T, x upon A minus x. We can rearrange this equation. X in upon A minus x is equal to A K2 T. And this equation is similar to straight line equation, y is equal to mx plus c, this straight line passing through origin. Then we plotting the graph x upon a minus x against the t, we obtain this straight line, and this straight line also passing through the origin. The slope of this straight line is equal to a k2. By knowing the slope, we can determine the rate constant. A is the initial concentration, it is a known value. We can determine the slope by plotting the graph x upon a minus x against the t, and by knowing the slope and initial concentration, we can determine the rate constant for second order reaction. Then consider, we again, this is the first type of graph. This is the second order, this is the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving single reactor and two reactor with equal initial concentration. This equation R, then we can rearrange this equation in this form, K2T is equal to 1 upon A minus X minus 1 upon A. By using this equation and this equation is same, we can rearrange this equation in this form. The K2T is equal to 1 upon A minus X minus 1 upon A, then 1 upon A minus X, 1 upon A minus X is equal to K2T plus 1 upon A. 1 upon A minus X is equal to, this is the left hand side K2T, this is the plus, this goes on the left hand side, it plus, become minus, become plus, the K2T plus 1 upon A. This is the equation number 2. This equation 2 is also similar to the general straight line equation, y is equal to mx plus c. M is the slope of straight line and c is the intersect of the straight line. Then we plotting the graph, then we again plot the graph, 1 upon A minus x, 1 upon A minus x against the t, we obtain this straight line. The straight line having a slope, the slope of the straight line is k2. The slope of this straight line is equal to k2, and this is the intersect. The intersect of this straight line is 1 upon A. We can rearrange the second order reaction integrated rate equation to different form. In this form, we discuss this equation. We rearrange the integrated rate equation for second order reaction in two different form. This is the first form. X upon A minus X is equal to K to T. This equation is similar to straight line equation. Or in this case, we can plot the graph x upon A minus x against the t. We obtain this straight line, and this straight line passing through the origin with slope of this straight line is equal to A k2. Also, we rearrange this equation in this form. 1 upon A minus x is equal to k2t plus 1 upon A. Then plotting the graph 1 upon A minus x against this t, we can obtain the again straight line. The straight line is obtained. The slope of this straight line is k2, and intersect of this straight line is equal to 1 upon A. These are the two different form of nature of graph for second order reaction involving single reactant and involving two reactants with equal initial concentration. Then consider the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactants. The integrated rate equation equation for second order reaction involving two reactants. The integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactants with unequal initial concentration. In this case, the integrated rate equation is K2 is equal to 2.303 A minus B into T log B into A minus X divided by A into B minus X. This is the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactants with unequal initial concentration. K2 is equal to 2.303 A minus B into T log B upon A minus X upon A into B minus X. Then we can rearrange this equation, log B into A minus X divided by A into B minus X is equal to, we can rearrange this equation, K2 A minus B into T divided by 2.303 log . This is the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving two reactants with unequal initial concentration. We rearrange this equation, log B into A minus X, A into B minus X is equal to the K2 A minus B. We can rearrange this K2 A minus B into T divided by 2.303. We can rearrange this according to rules of logarithm. We can write this log B plus A plus log A minus X upon B minus X. Then using the rules of logarithm, we can write log B into A minus X, A into B minus X is equal to log B upon A plus log A minus X upon B minus X is equal to K2 A minus B into T divided by 2.303. Then we can rearrange this again, log A minus 6 upon B minus 6 is equal to K2 A minus B divided by 2.303 into T minus log B upon A minus log B upon A. This is the equation number 3. Log A minus X, we can rearrange this equation in this form, log A minus X B minus X, log A minus X upon B minus X is equal to K2 A minus B upon 2.303 into T log minus log B upon A. This equation is also similar to the straight line equation y is equal to mx plus c. M is the slope and slope is equal to k2 a minus b upon 2.303 and intercept is minus log b upon a. We can plotting the graph. Will we again plot the graph, log a minus x upon b minus x against this time, we can obtain this straight line. The straight line have intercept minus log B upon A. It have intercept minus log B upon A and the slope of this straight line is equal to K2 A minus B upon 2.303. The slope of this straight line, K2 A minus B 2.303. By knowing the value of slope, we can determine the rate constant K2. If slope is known, then K2 is equal to 2.303 into slope divided by A minus B. A is the initial concentration of reactant A. B is the initial concentration of second reactant B. Then by knowing the slope K2, by knowing the slope we can determine rate constant. Substituting the value of the slope, which is obtained by using this straight line, 2.3032 slope divided by A minus B. It is a rate constant. Then by using the nature of graph, we can determine the rate constant for second order reaction involving two reactants with an equal initial concentration. This is the first characteristic for the second order reaction, graphical representation, that is the nature of graph. And consider the second characteristic for the second order reaction. Consider the second characteristic for the second order reaction, half life period. And half life period is represented by T half. The half life period is the time required for completion of 50% of reaction, is known as the half life period, or the time at which the 50% initial amount of reactant is reacted and leaving behind 50% initial amount of the reactant is unreacted. This time is known as half-life period. When the integrated rate equation for second order reaction involving single reactor and two reactors with equal initial concentration has equation K2 is equal to A into T X upon A minus X. Well, if A is the initial concentration, we consider A is the initial concentration, X is a reactant concentration, X is a reactant concentration, well, T is a T half, we consider the time is a half life, T is a T half, then X is equal to A by 2. At that time, reactive concentration is 50%. Initial concentration is A. When reaction does not start, at T is equal to T0. When X is the reactive concentration, at a time T is equal to T. When T is considered with T half, then we take the T is a T half. At that time, X reactive concentration is 50% of the initial concentration is A by 2. Then we can substitute T is equal to T half in integrated rate equation and X is equal to A by 2. Then K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T is equal to T half, X is equal to A by 2, A minus A by 2. Then we can solve this. K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T half. This is the A by 2. A minus A by 2 is A by 2. This A by 2, A by 2 get cancelled. Then K2 is equal to 1 upon A into T half. And the half life period of second order reaction is equal to 1 upon A into K2. This is the half-life period for the second order reaction involving single reactor and involving two reactors with equal initial concentration. T half is equal to 1 upon A into K2. This equation is the half-life period of second order reaction. This equation indicates that the half-life period of second order reaction is inversely proportional to the initial concentration of the reactor. The half-life period of second order reaction is inversely proportional to the initial concentration of the reactor. T half is equal to A upon 1 upon A into T. This is the half-life period equation for second order reaction. Then consider the third characteristic for the second order reaction. Consider the third characteristics, unit. Then what is the unit of second order reaction? This is the integrated rate equation for the second order reaction. K2 is equal to A into T x upon A minus x with single reactor and two reactor with equal initial concentration. And for the second case, with unequal initial concentration of two reactor, the integrator rate equation K2 is equal to 2.303 A minus B into T log B into A minus X upon A into B minus X. If T is a time and we measure this time in second, X is a reactive concentration, A is the initial concentration. If concentration we measure in mole per liter, then what is the unit of second order reaction? K2 is equal to, the concentration is mole per liter, time is second, this concentration is again mole per liter, A minus X, it is again concentration term, it is a mole per liter. This mole per liter get cancelled. The K2 is equal to 1 upon mole per liter. The unit of rate constant of second order reaction is liter per mole per second. This is the unit of second order reaction. If time is measured in second and concentration in mole per liter, then inverse of mole is per mole, inverse of per mole is mole, liter, per liter is liter, and inverse of second is per second. The unit of second order reaction is liter per mole per second. We also obtain by using this equation, K2 is equal to 2.303, A minus B is a concentration, it is a mole per liter, time in second, this again concentration term, mole per liter, this is also concentration term, mole per liter, this concentration term get cancelled, then K2 is equal to 1 upon mole per liter second. We take the inverse, the unit of second order reaction, liter per mole per second. The unit of second order reaction is liter per mole per second. These are the three characteristics we discuss for the second order reaction, nature of graph, then half-life period for second order reaction, and unit of